Coming to you live from Padme's bedroom with kittens in the corner, we're going to talk about squad placement. This is a big deal because when there's mass AoEs and a passive revive, team order matters. And we're going to take a look at why Jolie needs to be in the second slot, Daka needs to be in the second slot. Then we're also going to talk about mass assists, specifically with Geos. And it all comes from a conversation that I had with one of my mods the other day on Discord. Astar said, hey, this matters specifically with Geos. I tried doing a stream about it, and it didn't make a lot of sense, and it wasn't conclusive. But it finally came to fruition here in the dev post. We got to read this because we're going to explain the logic of why we're going to move these teams around into certain orders, because order and position in your placement does matter, and this post explains why. I would like to know what defines mass assists, attack orders such as General Kenobi's lead the charge, or C-3PO's oh my goodness abilities, for instance. Is it an animation delay, the order of the characters in the line, or something else? I ask it because last week, and I'm guessing they were on the stream or they heard it on somebody else's stream, I was told that you can optimize a Genosian team by choosing Alpha in position one, yes, Sunfect in position two, yes, Genosian shoulder in three, and so on. According to this guy, this would make Sunfect attack first, remove any buffs, then Genosian shoulder attacks and applies tenacity down, and finally Poggle would attack, applying ability block. Is that true, or the order in the line has nothing to do with attacks? And then this is like the worst answer ever. Do not like this answer at all. It says, this is a tricky one. While squad order placement plays a large role in the assist order, there are other factors at work here beyond that. If I were determined enough, I would experiment with your squad order placement until you find a result you're satisfied with. And note the changes to unit from what? Look at this right here. From mods to bug fixes may impact the order. So I've worked on this for about an hour, and I'm on Twitch right now, and everybody on Twitch chat has helped out a lot. So a big shout out to everybody on Twitch because we came up with this, and we're just going to go over all these teams right here. And there's two issues, the mass assists, and then we're also going to talk about revives, like on a JKR team with the Savior triggering in, making sure that it revives Jolie so that Jolie can revive the rest of the team. The same thing is true with Night Sister. So we're just going to go from top to bottom, and we're going to talk about all of these squads. And what I'm hoping is that the community will clearly define what's going on here, because we're going off of a little bit of anecdotal evidence, we're going off of logic, and we're also going off of this post. So let's get right into the first one right here, and this is 501st, and the idea here is that there is something wrong with Fives and his Savior mechanic not working correctly, and that Fives needs to go into the fifth slot. Next, we're going to talk about Padme. Now, there's two mass assists on this team, one with C-3PO, and then lastly with General Kenobi. And the idea here is that they will assist in order, Ahsoka, C-3PO, Jedi Anakin, General Kenobi, once that happens, based on their placement. Now, Padme has to go in the first slot, so nothing we can do about that. Ahsoka will dispel on her basic, and then you're going to get confusion from C-3PO, and then you're going to get a heal block, buff immunity from Jedi Knight Anakin's basic. And then lastly, General Kenobi has an opportunity to put foresight. So we came to conclusion that this would be the optimal squad order placement for the mass assist, because if they have something like crit hit immunity or tenacity up, Ahsoka will remove that. And so this seems to make the most sense. Next, we have to talk about Jedi Knight Revan. And this is a big deal. Jolie needs to go in the second slot. And the reason for this is if there is a massive AoE that comes in from like General Grievous and a bunch of characters die and the Savior triggers, you want that Jolie to revive before Bastila, before Grandmaster Yoda, before Hermit Yoda. If like four characters die at once, we want the Savior to revive Jolie before it revives Bastila, Grandmaster Yoda, Hermit Yoda. So we have to keep Jedi Knight Revan in the first slot, but Jolie needs to go in the second slot. kind of a big deal. Then Bastila applies on a mass assist, which we do have from Jedi Knight Raven. The rest of it is Bastila has ability block. Grandmaster Yoda, his basic attack will do two different things depending on how much health they got. And if they have under 50% health, he gets a chance to get offense up. And that seems to be useful. So putting him after Bastila makes the most sense because if they have less 50% health, then he'll gain offense up and defense penetration instead of the turn meter. And then it doesn't really matter where Hermit Yoda goes, so he's there at the end. Next, we're going to talk about the next team right here. And this is what started the whole conversation with me originally, is what is the optimal way to place Genosians? And the idea here is to put Sunfac first, because he will dispel all buffs. And then right here, we're going to have Genosian Soldier. On his basic attack, he will put Tenacity down, so more negative status effects will apply. And that's why Poggle goes last, because Poggle will do the ability block. And so that is the idea. Now, the cool thing about doing this is it probably works the way that we're describing it. The community has said, yes, this is how it works. It doesn't cost anything to move this around, and if it's only like 2% better, that's fine. It seems to make a difference. Next, we're going to keep going down the list, and we're just going to go through the same thing right here. Now, the idea here is Daka. So Night Sister Zombie can revive, and if there is a mass AoE, we want to give Daka the opportunity to revive first because she can revive the rest of the team. So it's the same thing with the Jedi Knight Savior and the passive revive ability. You want to make sure that it gets allocated to Jolie rather than somebody else. And so Daka needs to go in the second slot. Plus also too, if she stuns with her basic, the other attacks that come in behind on the assist from Mother Talzin's where they all assist, they can evade if they're stunned. Night Sister Zombie needs to go third right here because tenacity down, meaning more negative status effects will apply and so on. So this all makes sense so far. Are you with me? It's a pretty good system. And like I said, it doesn't really matter that much. Now, this is kind of interesting right here. And this really just depends on the bounty hunters that you're running. But the general idea is that pretty much want Embo in the second slot if you're running Embo. And then in the last slots, you want Dengar or Jango Fett. Now, I'm not running Jango, so Dengar is in the last slot. And the reason why Dengar is in the last slot here is because if they are severing any debuffs, he gets this bonus. And Jango Fett has an opportunity to attack a second time, so Jango Fett would want to go into the last slot. And Embo would make sense to go into the second slot. But in this team right here, the only thing that matters is that Dengar is in the last slot. Okay, we're going to go down to the next one. And not so important here on troopers. The idea here is we want Stark in the second slot right here because he can put defense down. And then we've got Death Trooper here in the third slot because if he's able to apply the stun, the next two hits from the characters behind him, which would be the Snow Trooper and the Range Trooper, can't be evaded because if a character is stunned, then they can no longer evade. So it's very interesting how all of this works. And I'm hoping that we get a conversation started and we actually get to know, but I'm pretty sure this is the way it works. Everybody's been talking about it. Nuke Gunray. Nuke Gunray has a mass attack with only the Separatists. So I'm running this here with Nest. So Nest is not really a part of this equation. And the idea here is Dooku's basic has an opportunity to inflict stun. So if they're stunned, they can no longer evade. When Wat Tambor attacks out of turn on his basic, he applies a damage over time, which means that there will be a negative status effect. And then Jango will be attacking last, and if they have a debuff, he can attack a second time. What if this makes the difference in your grand arena, and it's just about moving your squad positions around? It's really that simple. I think it's a big deal. And plus, they're all in save squads anyways, right? Lastly, we're going to talk about Ewoks, and then we're going to do a giveaway. And the idea here on Ewoks is that Paplu, on his basic, dispel, so clear away the tenacity up, maybe crit hit immunity, something like that. Tenacity has removed. Ewok Elder just basically gives turn meter, and I think that would be good to get that turn meter if let's say Chirpa attacks, Papalu attacks, Ewok gets the final blow. I would rather have Ewok Elder get the final blow than Wicket or Logway, because at least Ewok Elder will be giving Termeater for the rest of the team. And then Wicket before Logway. This is a very subtle thing. It's because he gives crit chance up, possibly to an ally, where that seems to be more important than Logway's, which is Tenacity up. So if you have other teams like Hux team or Kira lead, they have mass assist as well. So we're talking about attack order and mass assist. I mean, there are bunches of other team compositions. You can put that down in the comment section below if you want to include what order you think is the best. So guess what time it is? That's right. Right now it's time for the giveaway. Well, I really hope you liked this video today, because if you did, you are in luck. For every single person that likes this video, you will be getting for free in your account an 8-star CG Top Cash.
This is not a scam.
All right, guys. Thanks for watching and keep on gaming.